A solar eclipse is an alignment between the sun, the moon, and the earth in that order. So as the earth is going around the sun with the moon going around the earth, you can have occasionally a time when the moon lines up perfectly with the sun's position, thus blocking the light from the sun and casting a shadow over earth. If you walk outside and you look at the sun, which you should never do without protection, but if you did, you would find that you could cover it with your thumb. If you do the same thing on a full moon night, you'll find you can also cover it with your thumb. While the sun is 400 times larger than the moon is 400 times closer than the sun is. So they can have the same apparent size in the sky, and when that happens and they align, you can get the moon completely blocking the sun. My experience with a total solar eclipse goes back to 2017, where we had the Great American Eclipse. We had a total solar eclipse that passed over the United States. And I had my nephew with me at the time, he was 7, and we packed up and went to Casper, Wyoming, which was in the path of totality. I took a lot of care to try and find the place with the best weather, because weather is gonna make or break your day. So we were ready to go the moment that the moon entered the disk of the sun. And then we watched as it slowly crept across the disk of the sun. You see the last moments of light that are leaving the sun, passing through these troughs of mountains on the moon. The sun gets covered with these tiny dots of light that are called Bailey's beads. And the very, very last one creates a diamond ring effect with the corona of the sun, this plasma that surrounds the sun, for a second. And then all of a sudden, in a moment that feels too epic to possibly give words to, you go instantaneously from day to dusk with the sun and the corona and the stars coming out. That to me is the most epic kind of immersion in an astronomical phenomenon you can get.
Oh my God!
Oh my God!
Whoa. Are you kidding me?
Oh my God!
Oh my God!
The Earth is not the only planet in the solar system to have eclipses, and it's not the only one to have total solar eclipses. Mercury and Venus don't have moons, so they're out. Mars has two moons, but Mars's moons are too small and too far away to give total solar eclipses. Then there's the outer solar system. Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune, even dwarf planet Pluto have moons that are really big and close enough that they provide not just eclipses, but total solar eclipses at some point during their year.
Back here on Earth, we get a total solar eclipse on average every 18 months.
We do not get eclipses at the same time or the same place every year. We don't even get them every month. And the reason for that is that the moon's orbit as it's going around Earth is actually off by about 5 degrees. 5 degrees may not sound like a lot, but actually in space, that turns out to be quite a large number, at least large enough that every 28 or so days, we're not getting an eclipse. And then, remember, Earth is spinning, Moon is spinning, and as those spins are happening, as they're both moving around the sun, they're constantly changing the positions they might be in at the time that the moon lines up with the sun. It changes where it is on the planet, and it changes the length of time that it's gonna happen on the planet too. Staring at the sun is never a good idea. It's not safe. There's a lot of harmful radiation that comes from the sun. So there are eclipse viewing glasses. They are certified so that you know that standards have been put in place to make sure that your eyes are protected. You also don't actually have to look at the sun. You could project the sun onto the ground, onto a cloth, onto something else so that you're not actually looking at the sun, but you're looking at the projection of the sun, and it unfolds like a movie in front of you with the moon passing in front of it. If this excites you and you want to go see it, then look up on an eclipse map, the path of totality, because it's narrow and you gotta see if you can get there, but I encourage everyone that can to participate in this awesome astronomical event.